can remain, you can stay there since you're already here. Just hang out until it's your turn. It's fine.
Okay.
You're concerned.
He's 4:15.
Oh.
He's 4 o'clock. He's 4:15.
Okay, Rogelio. How's that? That's a smile. Well, you know, people don't realize this, but the Youth Commission is one of the most important departments or organizations we have in the city right now. The city of Reading is in the midst of a complete takeover of new people. And these people have to be, we have to understand them, okay? Now, you know what the purpose of the Youth Commission is?
To my knowledge, I know that the Youth Commission is a group of young adults like myself who have the opportunity to speak and express our thoughts and ideas on issues pertaining to the city.
Yes. And why are you interested in serving on the commission?
When I found out what the Youth Commission was and did, I knew I wanted to be a part of this group. I've lived in the city my whole life, and I know there's a ton of issues that could use some resolving and help from someone like myself.
And you won't have any problems attending meetings?
I don't think so.
What date are the meetings, Shelley?
They are the first Wednesday of every month at 6 p.m. via Zoom.
Oh, yeah, I'll have no issue at all.
What would you like to see this commission accomplish when you get in there?
I'd like to see a strong connection with the city officials, along with the city people, and I'll be able to give my insight and ideas to help support the problems here in the city.
And what concerns do you have? This would be your same answer, right?
Yeah.
Well, right now, we do have a problem in the city with our youth.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I guess you know what the three most important issues are facing the youth today. You know what they are?
I'm assuming here in the city specifically, it'll have to be do with gun violence.
Yes.
Mental issues, like mental health issues.
Depressions,
yes. And the third one could be drug use, alcohol abuse. That's, in my opinion, what the three major problems are.
And I must agree with you, okay? If we could get a hold of these things and put them in a bag, and tie that bag up and throw it in the river, we would really clean up the mess.
Yes, sir.
You're in college right now?
Yes, sir.
And you're going for what degree?
Electromechanical engineering technology.
Nothing to do with what you're going to be working on?
No.
Well, I'm sure there's something there. You'll find it. You'll find it. And you're willing to work on any kind of project? Have you thought about what you'd like to present yourself that we should be doing or the commission should be doing?
I really, in my mind, I really want to support getting rid of the gun violence.
Okay.
If I could work on a project related to that, I'd try my best to help prevent it because, like I said, I've lived here my whole life. I've witnessed things that people my age never have. So if there's any project relating that, I'd love to get on that and try my best to help.
We don't have anybody else to raise any other questions.
No, it's just you.
Is there any comment you would like to make? Any closing comment?
Thank you very much for the opportunity of interviewing me.
Okay. And we need more people like you that are not just interested in getting their name on a piece of stationery, but are going to come on board with these commissions and board member and boards to accomplish something or come in with some ideas how to clear up the problems we're having in the city.
Okay.
And you'll be contacted by Shelley here in regards of coming in and signing some paperwork, and she'll let you know what the final, well, we'll be voting on this one.
Monday.
Okay.
So you'll be notified immediately.
All right.
And thank you.
All righty. Thank you very much.
That's it.
Now you have Mark. Mark is at 4:15.
Have a good night.
Thank you. Good night. Good night.
Thank you.
Mark, I thought that you, I was looking at your application here, and I thought you lived outside this city.
Nah.
Yeah.
Nah.
I had, as a patrolman, I patrolled that district all the way out River Road.
Yeah. And you I know what? I haven't seen a police car. Every once in a while, I see a police car out there. Thank God we live in a very nice, in my opinion, little area of the city that nobody forget, everybody forgets about.
It's and there.
That's okay with me. But yeah, no, I'm within the city.
Okay. Mark, let me ask you something. Why are you interested in serving on this, on the Code and License Appeal Board?
Well, an honest story is my wife, Pam, was serving on that board.
Yes, I remember that.
She was asked to serve on the redistricting committee. She got talked in and she had interest in that. Linda Kelleher asked her if I would be, and I was on the parking authority for 5 years. Mayor McMahon put me on. Mr. Mayor Vaughn Spencer fired me within like 4 months till my end of my 5-year term. And he put Aaron Lloyd in my place, which, whatever. However, so I've been involved with, some volunteer work and some service work within the city of Reading. We built our house there in 1989 in the city limits. I still live there. I have two rental units, one at 912 Weiser Street in Donna Reed's district, and one at 526 South 7th Street that I'm in the process of selling, but I'm getting ready to retire here. I'm 65, I'll be 66 next year.
Oh, you're young.
I am young, yes. I'm not going to retire and drop dead or drop off the face of the earth. But you know what I mean? I can take a break maybe next year, a year or two, you know, a little bit. But in any event, to be honest, I didn't know much about this board. I know my wife's involvement with the board. She thought it was interesting. Like I said, she was asked to take a position on this redistricting board, which she is very interested in. And I said, yeah, if it's doesn't seem to be too time consuming. I'm still working 40 hours a week. I'm still I'm the president of a Victor Emanuel's. I'll be president until the end of this year. I've coached soccer at the Soccer Club of Reading and Reading Berks United for 17 years. So I wasn't on anything anymore. So I thought this would be something. I don't know.
Well, I really believe with your wife having the background she has concerning this board, that she's going to be a tremendous, tremendous asset to you serving on this board.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what's your opinion on the needs for a city appeals board? Why do you think we should have this?
Well, I think some of the issues that the city is facing, and when they go to make a decision on what to do to solve these issues on the people that are perpetrating these problems, if they don't like the result, I think there should be a means and a way to appeal that decision, if you will. And, I think the appeal process is part of our judicial system. So I think it's necessary. And it's also, it may give them a comfort factor feeling that they have the ability to do such an appeal. It's not a cut case. You're done. I don't care what. It may give them a sense of, the city is trying to make some effort to put in place this committee to listen to appeals and to see if the judgment was correct or incorrect. It gives them a chance to be heard, I think, again.
Yes.
I don't know. Am I wrong?
No, you're not wrong.
You're wrong.
I'm going to make a comment here, and you tell me if I'm wrong, okay?
Yeah.
When these appeals come in front of city council, after listening to so many appeals for so many years that I've been here, a lot of those appeals shouldn't even be here. But the problem doesn't start with us. It starts with the realtors and people that are selling these properties, the people, and not telling them what the rules and regulations are. Okay? And after they sell this property, you can't go back to them. They don't want to hear it.
Yeah.
They have your money. They tell you to appeal it to the city.
Yeah.
Okay? Now, we have the burden now of straightening out a problem that somebody made money on, and we had no problem. We had nothing to do with it.
Nothing to do
with it. But you agree with this.
Oh, yeah, no. I think to get the city gets stuck in a hard position with these people, selling units. They don't know how to maintain them. They don't know how to properly go through the housing permitted process. They have people other than themselves living in these buildings. I have two rental properties myself. They're all legit, if you will, but they don't understand the codes process. They don't understand some of the ordinances. They don't understand a lot of what goes into, let's say, a rental unit. You know, it's not just you buy a house and you rent it out and you're done,
Right. But that person that's filing this, okay, he should have been told about this before he ever purchased the building, that you can do this and you can do that. But they're not. They're not.
Yeah. Good idea, bad idea. I don't know. It would be nice if... Maybe the city could reach out to all the area realtors and send a brochure or something explaining, hey, if you sell a property, either it's going to be your permanent residence or you're purchasing a property that's going to be a rental unit, these are the steps you have to take to become compliant,
Yes.
I don't know.
And we've talked about this every time. We get a case in front of us where you can see that the parties are there and they have attorneys and everything.
Yeah.
But the attorney can't do anything. Yeah. The law is the law.
Oh, yeah.
That's it. Now, we try to help them, try to do something for them, at least to try and satisfy the situation. But again, it all goes back to the original person that's unloading the problem to somebody else.
Oh, yeah. I agree.
Yeah.
I agree. And you know what? I am in the process of selling a unit that I owned for, I think we owned it for 12 years or so. And I'm selling it. The market's right. I'm going into retirement soon. This is South 526 South 7th Street, right up from the Ukrainian Club.
Yeah.
Love the people on the block. When I come there to visit or do some, looking around or collect rent or repairs. Oh, the people come. I'll tell you a story. I was there before I bought the property. I don't want to hold you up, but I was there before I bought the property and I took possession of the property. The neighbor saw me around there. I'm coming around the turn, and I have a flat tire. And the tire is going boop, boop, boop. And honest to God, I pulled up in front of the house. The neighbors came out. Jacks, they had my car, honest to God, jacked up. Wheel took off. They took my tire and wheel, put it in a van. Nobody said anything. It was like a NASCAR pit stop. Honest to God, took my tire to get repaired. Came back, put the tire back on my car, left the jack down. He said, we see you have flat. We fix your flat. We know you're a good person. I'm going, are you kidding me? I mean, honest to God, true story. Don't want to hold you up. But
no, you're not holding me up. Now, there is no special time or date, okay?
Yes.
When you meet, when something is needed to be taken care of, that's when they call a meeting and you guys try to get it straightened out. But you won't have any problem with this?
No, no. And I spoke to Linda about this before. I said, right now I'm working, you know, 40 hours a week, but fortunately we're winding down here. So I have the luxury of, if I have to do an interview like this or something, I have the luxury to do that. Okay. Thank God. So that's fine. I believe I got an invitation for something in February regarding this ATV and off-road motorcycle issues you guys are having.
Yeah, well,
yes, that's correct.
I don't have anything else. And I think you'll be a tremendous asset to this group. Okay?
No, good. Good, I appreciate that.
Can I order my license for next year for over to club?
Yeah. Yeah, 2022 already. Yeah, 2022 is, we have them available for you.
I was a member when they were down at 2nd and Penn.
Yeah, I remember going down. I was a kid. That was pre-1972, Reading Redevelopment Authority came in and put the Holiday Inn or whatever it was.
Yeah.
Yeah, where Rack is now. Yeah, I remember being down there.
I knew all them guys, all of them.
I'm sure you do.
Okay. Thank you again for applying. And like I said, you'll make a good, good member of this organization.
No, I hope so.
And Shelly will be contacting you.
Okay.
After we vote on this as to what's going to take place, okay?
Yep, that's great. And I apologize for butting in on the
briefing. No.
I had one at 4 o'clock and one that said 4:15. I didn't know. So I did 4 o'clock.
No problem. And again, thank you.
Yeah. Merry Christmas to you if I don't talk to you.
Same to you.
Take care.
Yep.
Bye, Shelly.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Recording stopped.
Okay.